for some easy ones. Basically. Still a little slow, but it was good. Mentally, I was able to get a couple of fouls out of it, if you could.
If you look at the game in general, you know, it was a really good start first half. Then, as Mike said, you know, didn't really have a lot of juice second half.
Yeah, I mean, it's kind of been an issue for us, you know, all season. We always, every time we get a big lead, we always kind of sort of let go. We got to correct that, especially now. We got to have a better attitude about it. I mean, give them credit too. You know, they didn't quit. They made plays, but that's expected. You know, we stayed at the game. Seems like we keep fighting. You know, we came back and made plays, enough plays to win the game, but we gotta you know, keep our foot on the gas like, the whole game. You know, sometimes have that bad habit of, you know, letting the lead slip away. So hopefully this, you know, it's the last time we have this, and we can erase that, and moving forward we keep our gas on.
Is that just mindset?
Yeah, it is. It really is. I think that, especially tonight, the way we were playing, especially defensively, I think. We look at how we play in the third quarter. We gave them a lot of easy stuff in the transition basket, miscommunication. We just were not as tight as early in the first half. You know, in the first half, we were really tight. Everybody was on the same page. Our rotations were on point. The second half, we kind of just relaxed a little bit, and they were able to like get some easy baskets, some silly fouls. But we can correct that, and we need to correct that moving forward. I think, like I said, hopefully this is the last time it happens.
Luke, what about James and CP3 when they're locked in the way they were, especially in that first half, how dynamic this offense is when both of them are doing that?
Yeah, obviously, those guys are top guards. You know, they're the best at what they do. So we need them at that level, all series and the rest of the way. So when they play like that, it's big for us. But offensively, I know they're going to be good. You know, for me, it's defensive. When James and CP are locked up defensively, I always trust PJ, Trev, and Clint. So those two, when they're locked up, we're clicking. We're pretty good, and we get stops. Our offense is just, you know, flows most of the time. So they did a really good job tonight coming in with the mindset of attacking from the goal and not being hesitant, just going downhill, especially James, just going downhill and taking the shots, putting pressure on the defense, and he's in for us.
What kind of relief was it for you to knock down your first shot and hit a three to sort of start things off to?
Let you relax and just sort of play around.
That was good, especially with that small lineup. They really put a big on me. They put a small on Ryan. So, you know, just exploring the defense. I was kind of upset. I missed my next shot. So it's always good to make your first shot. Obviously, that's the shot that I know is going to be there because of the matchups and how they play us. So I'm just ready to step into it and knock it down. So. It's good. Yeah, offensively, it's going to come. Obviously, it's going to take me a little bit of time because of the, you know, you're not in rhythm. You know, you're just not in rhythm. Defensively, for me, that was the main thing. You know, making sure my legs and, you know, closing out, moving, staying in front of guys, especially my vision. He's been playing really well. That was my main concern. You know, contesting, you know, putting my hand up and all that stuff. So, offensively, it's going to come.
About three possessions later, you set a hard screen on Favors, led with your right shoulder. Was that the kind of hit you were talking about before that you needed to get?
Yeah, definitely. I had another one too at the end of the game. That was pretty good. And I fouled Gobert. I felt that one. But yeah, that was definitely one of those. And like I told Coach yesterday, I mean, when I play, I play. You know, I'm not going to think of all, you know, this big deal or whatnot. I play. It's my first time going through this, so obviously I know what to expect. But I'm just out there, you know. Playing hard. I know I've done everything I need to do to be good, so it's why I play.
You lived to what you said before the game. No dunks.
No dunks. Yeah. For now, you know, just no dunks. So I'm sure the training staff is going to be happy about it. You never know. I mean, you know, after a week or two, I might feel too good about myself and dunk. But for now, you know, I was talking to Chris. He was talking about working on floaters, which I don't usually do. So it's either layoff or dunks. But we'll see. No dunks.
Obviously, before the season, did you ever wonder how the James and Chris pairing would work? And is this kind of how you envisioned it, or is it different in any way?
Not at all. I mean, so, you know, preseason, we got together in the summer and we started working out and playing. And from then on, you know, we could tell it was a good connection between those guys. And we could tell that we were together. And obviously, the numbers and our team wins and all that stuff speak for themselves. And they've been really, really good. You know, I think, like I said earlier, when those guys are playing at a high level, like they have been all season, we're really good. So I'm not surprised. Like I said earlier, from the start of the season, even like I said, summer, I could tell it was already going to be a good connection.
We made a lot of shots, they kept their rhythm, they would keep running, whenever we were missing or having decision, they were just playing their game, hot pace, a fast break, layups, threes, open shots. So we had to do that to get our focus back. And next game, we're going to have to keep that focus up in the third quarter.
You're pretty happy with the way the team started. Uh-huh. You're pretty happy with the way you guys started this game.
It was a goal for us also. The two games, we haven't been really starting in the right way. So that's the way we it was our main focus to start in that way. We did really well. So it's a goal for us. So after the halftime, we can get more in our focus and we did it the right way.
Rudy's one of the best in the league, protecting the rim but still defending his own guy. Mm-hmm. How is it you've been able to get touches and finish against him so much this season?
Especially today. I know the guy. I know him all the time. He's a smart guy. He has the ability. He's strong, so he has the ability to be on Chris and on me, or on him to me. So every time I was getting the ball, I knew that I had to come to finish. Because of his length, he cannot finish off on the line. So it was important for me to finish hard.
Is that what you've done? Because it's not just today, it's throughout the season. Yeah. You guys have done well.
We all know that around him, you have to finish hard. Because finish over him, it's pretty hard with his length. Today we did a good job. We have more games. I know next game is going to be more wear, so it's going to be harder. Thank you guys.